the face because of your
I just messed you up.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Richa, a second year engineer at Mansfield College, Oxford, and today I'm here with my friend Ben.
I am also a second year engineer at Mansfield.
So today we're going to give you a brief overview of the engineering admission process for Oxford. And before we get started, can you provide a brief background of yourself? Where did you attend high school? Which A-levels you did?
Yeah, so originally I'm from New Zealand, and I moved to England when I was pretty young and did high school in Suffolk and went to a sixth form college in Norfolk. I did maths, physics and further maths A-level.
Okay, so very sciencey subjects.
Yeah.
And the first thing, of course, is your UCAS application. We're not going to talk much about it because it remains same subject to subject except the personal statement. So what tips do you have for someone writing an engineering personal statement?
I think one of the things I did was I made it like a bit too personal, and I kind of realized like you don't need to show off your personality. You just kind of need to tick boxes. Like show a little bit, but like it's mainly just ticking boxes, and it's like if yours is the same as everyone else's, it's not a bad sign. Like standing out of the crowd isn't really an important thing to do. I don't know if you agree. Do you agree?
I guess I do agree, but it's also good to show like a bit of yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, at the end of the day, like they want to know if you can work in like a tutorial system and if you do have the personality to like think. So yeah, but like apart from that, I do agree. A lot of it is just listing your achievements and the things you did.
Oh yeah, like also I did this online course in robotics, and it was like a week long course from like some university in Australia, but it only took like 5 hours. So it looked really good, but it wasn't that much work. So it's worth getting some of them down.
So and did you apply to an open or to a specific college, or was it like an open application?
Yeah, I applied to Mansfield, but like not really for any good reason. I went on the summer school, the unique summer school here, and I won like a mug from Mansfield College. So I couldn't go to another college with a Mansfield mug. So, you know.
Yeah. And like another thing is, how far back did you decide to apply to Oxford itself? Because you went to the unique summer school, so is it because you already knew that you were thinking about Oxford?
No, so I probably like after the unique summer school, I thought, I probably won't apply there. So I kind of thought it'd be a bit of a wasted option. But then like some people, I spoke to like a few people, and they're like, yeah, it's actually not that. Like some other people that have been, and they were like, yeah, it's not actually that hard to get into. Like you might as well apply. And like you realize you probably will get like other options because you only get 5, but like 5 is quite a lot, so like it's not really a waste of an option even if you don't get in.
It's always better to try than to not apply at all. And so the next thing, of course, is the entrance test. So how did you prepare for the entrance test, Ben?
So maybe like 4 or 5 days before it, I just like in the evening, so I just started doing like some old questions, found some website where someone put up their solutions. But yeah, I think like the main thing was just to like be chilled out, and also like remember it's not an A-level paper and you don't need to get full marks. You just need to show like what you're thinking, get all your workings down so they can kind of see how you're approaching problems. Because like as soon as you approach a problem right, it doesn't really matter whether you get it right or not. It's the fact that you had the like full, I don't know, originality or something to get it, to know how to do it.
I completely agree with Ben. Like, past papers are the way to go by preparing for the entrance exam, because they're like the only thing which are perfectly aligned to the test, and they also give you like an idea of where you stand depending on how much you can solve of the past papers. And then how did you feel coming out of your test? Did you feel like it went really well, or did you feel like you had messed it up?
So I was like kind of lucky enough, like on the summer school, everyone had kind of said like you don't, it's not the kind of paper where you get full marks. Like you'll probably get like 40% or something, and that's like good. So like I wasn't too worried because I kind of knew that was how it was. But yeah, I can imagine if it was your first, if you didn't know that, it would be quite scary if you came out and like you're used to getting 90s and then like you've only answered half the questions. But yeah, like so it like probably if you are worried, it probably isn't actually that bad.
Yeah, I agree. And so then the next step is the interview. And did you fly in for your interview, or did you have a Skype interview?
No, yeah, so mine was on Skype. and it was actually, I'd just flown out, and it was like the morning after I'd gotten in, so I was a bit jet lagged and tired.
Aww.
And it was quite early morning, but yeah, it was all right.
And how did the interview go? Like, what kind of questions did they ask you?
So I had to draw a graph. I think it was like, just sketching a graph. It was like x squared times e to the minus modulus of x. So I had to sketch that. That was all right. And then...
You had to like differentiate and stuff. Like, they basically were trying to figure out if you could differentiate and... I mean, plot like two functions simultaneously.
Yeah. Yeah, so there was that, and then there was like another mechanics question about, it was just like kind of draw a free body diagram and do some calculations. And then there was another one. Most of the problems were just about setting the problem up. Like as soon as you had it set up, it was fine. But they were just kind of like, because they don't really care about like how good at like the actual calculations you are. It's more just like, can you figure out how you're going to do something?
And the third problem was about the friction one, right?
Yeah, so there was like, it was like you were in a field, and then there was a road with a bridge, and you had to get to the bridge, and they like you knew the friction stuff for the road and the field, and you could like set up a function like to see if you would do more. I guess it's work done, but like lose more energy if you like went diagonal across the field, or if you went straight to the road and then along the nice smooth road to get to the bridge. So yeah, like as soon as it was one of them problems, like it sounded weird to start with, but as soon as you set it up, it's not too bad.
Yeah, I mean, we had the same questions because we interviewed in the same year, and I think one other useful tip is like to think out loud, like just don't try the final answer down, like try to think, like show them your thought process, because they're more interested in like your thought process than whether you get your final answer or not. So make sure you're saying everything out loud.
Yeah.
And how did you feel coming out of the interview?
I was quite glad it was done, and like I thought, I don't know, I think it went okay. I guess it did go okay, but yeah, I wasn't too worried. There's not really much you can do at that point.
Yeah, I mean, it's done. Like, there's no point in stressing about it. I mean, they're designed to be a bit challenging, but don't let that put you down. I think a lot of it is just trying to see whether you can work well in the tutorial system or not. And even throughout the interview, I mean, they do keep guiding you. It's not like they leave you or you like put you on the spot to do it by yourself. So don't worry about that. And yeah, I guess so. That's it for today. If you have any more questions which we haven't answered, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. And if you're a prospective applicant, good luck with your applications, and we hope to see you here next year. See ya!
See ya!